By now, I'm sure you guys have heard of Seedance, aka the VO3 killer. Seedance is a video generation model by ByteDance, and many have been saying that it's producing video content with quality as good as, if not better, than VO3. So, in this video, I'm going to do a build along of an AI marketing agent workflow which researches video ideas using Perplexity and prompts Seedance video generation model via API. At the end of it, you'll have an AI marketing agent that can generate video based on latest trends and output Instagram or TikTok ready content right into your phone. So, let's get right into it. So jumping right into the build, the first thing you want to do is create your first trigger node. In this case, I want it to be a Telegram on message trigger node, just because that's how I want the whole workflow to start, so that I could just send messages through Telegram from my phone to the workflow, and the workflow can just kick out the video output to my Telegram on my phone, right? So in this case, I've already set up my Telegram account. And if you don't know how to do that, check out my other video, which I'll guide you on a step-by-step guide on how to get set up on Telegram with your end-to-end. I'll link it up here, down here. So in this case, we've already set that up. What we want to do is we want to try to execute step and test it out. And so you can see I created a bot called the Seedance Video Gen. And this is the default message. And so you can see it's receiving that message on end-to-end. It's receiving a whole chunk, but as you know, we're interested in the content. The rest are kind of the timestamps and all the related information about the message. Okay, so that's the trigger node. And the next node that we want to punch in is the Perplexity node, because this is going to be the research agent that we're going to use to research all the trends in the internet that we can use for our marketing video, right? So in this case, we're going to call it the trend research agent, right? And then we're going to call it, we're going to use the Sona Pro model. And for the system message, and again, system message is basically telling the model what the core of the job that it's supposed to do, right? So in this case, it's supposed to research trends, et cetera. We're telling it and prompting it that. And then the user prompt is basically the message that you would put into, let's say, for example, if you're chatting with ChatGPT, that's what you put into it, right? So so system prompt, what I did was just go to ChatGPT and try to prompt engineer it. And in this case, I have it ready here, so I'm going to paste it in. And as you can see, it's just describing, sorry, just take that out. You're a trend research assistant for a creative video marketing workflow based on users' input, you know, research trend within the past 14 days, whatnot. You're responsible for passing to video prompt generator mode node. And here we specify the output, right? A trend title, summary, video angle suggestion, and source URL if required. So that's the system prompt. And as for the user prompt, we just want to direct this particular message from Telegram, because remember, what we're going to do is we're going to text on Telegram and say, hey, create a video based on X and X trend, or try to find some research on certain trends and let me know if you could generate a video, right? So that's what we're doing. And with that, we're going to test the node out. And I don't think it's going to generate anything meaningful because the input is just backslash start, but I think it's going to be forced to, as you can see, yeah, it's forced to research the trend because of the system message, right? So that's what it's supposed to do for 5 seconds Instagram. Okay, cool. So the third note that we want to punch in is the is it just a simple OpenAI message model node. And this node, what it does is it's basically a video prompt engineer. Okay, so what we want it to do is to take those ideas that's been researched by Perplexity and basically turn that into an optimized video prompt so that it could kick out that prompt straight to the Seedance API, and then Seedance can generate that video and kick it back out onto the Telegram chat. All right, so in this case, we're gonna just choose a model. Let's do a GPT, let's do the latest, okay. And again, for prompt, for the system prompt, you can engineer it with ChatGPT. So it does a great job at giving you a optimized prompt. In this case, basically it says you're a creative video prompt generator for short forms ads. Your task is to craft a concise, visually descriptive video generation prompt suitable for inputs for Seedance API, right? So so this is kind of the example output that we want. So yeah, and again, you can customize that as you want, but that's good enough for now. And for the user prompt, we want to direct this. So let me just do that. So it's under choices. So there's a few. So with Perplexity, there's a few ranges of output. So what you want to do is to come under choices, and from there, drag the content to the prompt field. And it's going to be a whole chunk of text. Doesn't matter, because the engineer, I mean, the video prompt engineer node is going to fix all of that and basically generate out a easy to read kind of prompt, right? So there you go. So a bold, glowing, tap the start button, pulses, So it's very detailed, very descriptive, kind of prompt for the video, so that Seedance actually can generate something that's really good for you, right? So the quality of the video itself is dependent on the quality of your prompt, so which is why it's super important for you to have a video prompt engineer in your workflow, right? So once that's done, what you want to do is head over to the HTTP request node In this case, we're going to call it C dance, or in this case, it's wave dance, right? Because as you can see later on, that's where we're going to get our C dance APIs, right? So just go to wave speed. Sorry, not wave dance, wave speed. All right. WaveSpeed AI, this is just one of the ways that you can get the CDance API right now on the internet, basically. So what you want to do is sign up, and I've already signed up, but essentially once you sign up, you get a, you know, $1 credit, whatnot. And from there, you know, you go to the dashboard, and basically it's got a bunch of models that you can pick from, and you go to Explorer, you'll see that it's got the CDance V1 Pro, and then it's got the other CDance with, it's basically just a difference in the quality of the output. So this is 1080, this is 720, so we're going to pick this one, right? And once you see this, what you want to do is head over to, to API, and then here's the curl command. So what you want to do is just copy that and go back to your workflow and hit import curl and copy the whole thing, right? Click on import. So it's going to just convert all of that curl command into, you know, all these very nice fields. So what you want to do is, you know, put the authentication in. So in this case, choose generic credential type. What you want to do is choose header auth and create new credential. And this is where you want to specify your CDance API. And go back to the page. And so you can see there's a tab called the API keys. And you need to create your API keys here. So anydn API keys, let's name it that. Create the key and just copy that. So before I paste it in, you might want to look at the API, or rather the curl command. So what it says here is, you can see in the header part, there is the authorization as a name, and bearer is part of the value of the API key that you're going to put in as well, right? So for those of you who are kind of confused in how curl works and how the API connection works, I have a separate video, again, I'll link it up there down here for you to check out. But essentially, because we have an authorization here, what you want to punch in the name is authorization, and what you want to put into the value, I'll toggle this to expression for now so that you can see, is bearer space and then the whole API chunk, right? All right, so then you can click on save. All right, so now your CDance, or rather the WaveSpeed API has been configured. You don't need the header authorization anymore because you've already set it up right here, so you can toggle this off. So under the body, there are a couple of fields here. So duration is basically just how long the video is, and 5 seconds is the minimum, and it's kind of the right sweet spot where we want the video to be anyway. Image is interesting because basically if you have an existing image that you want CDance to work on to animate based off, you can do that. So this is an actual really interesting use case. But in this case, we're not going to do anything. We don't have an existing image. We're just going to create everything from scratch. So we're going to leave that blank. So prompt is the one where we want to make sure that it's getting the prompt that is being output by the previous video prompt engineer, right? So, all right. So everything else, just leave it as that, and we're going to execute step. Okay. So as you can see, what happens here, you're getting a bunch of results. So status is created. So what this is this is a post request, and post request is basically us making a request to WaveSpeed in this case, basically to generate the video, right? So it's currently taking its time to generate that video. So what we do is we want the workflow to wait for, let's say, 30 seconds. Okay. All right, execute step. All right, we're gonna wait, that's gonna wait for 30 seconds. But right after, as we're waiting for that, we can set up the next node, which is the other HTTP request get node, right? So the idea is we're going to wait 30 seconds for the video to be generated, and then we're going to try to get that particular video. Now, how to get that particular video is basically the curl command right here. So you know, if you go back to ByteDance documentation, just copy that. And then same thing, you can just import the whole thing. But actually, it's just a URL, right? But you can import the whole thing, it's the same. So authentication, you want to use the same authentication that you had earlier, which is the header auth and CDance API. Again, once you've set that up, you can toggle this off. So everything else, you know, basically you can leave as is. The only important bit is making sure that you are pasting the right request ID in here, right? So I'm waiting for the previous node to be done because it's going to kick out the request ID, and then I'm going to paste it as a variable here. Okay, so that's done, and we're getting the results. And so just to backtrack a little bit, in layman terms, basically, we posted the request to WaveSpeed to generate the video, and now we want to get that particular video. Now, in order for WaveSpeed to know which particular video you want, because it has a bunch of videos in there, you need to provide the request ID that you posted earlier, right? So that's why this request ID is important to be replaced with this request ID that we have from the earlier node, right? So it knows which video to fetch. So now that's pasted on there. We're going to execute step. And cool. All right. So we're getting a bunch of stuff here. So let's just furl that up. And the first thing that you want to pay attention to is the status, right? So a lot of times the status, if it's in the midst of processing the video, it's going to say processing instead of complete, right? And what we have here is completed. So, you know, it's just going to have an output of the video. So let's just check this out because it's interesting to see what we're going to get without actually having any prompt. So it's somehow getting, it's doing an ad perfume. It's kind of with, is that Russian? I'm not sure. Maybe it's gibberish. But yeah, so that's without any prompt at all. So let's just go back. But yeah, so this is completed. And basically what you want to do now is to kick this output, this URL out to back to your Telegram chat. Telegram, send a message. So we're going to add Telegram send a message node. Send a text message. Send a message, chat ID. Okay, so we need to tell Telegram which chat ID it's supposed to send it to. So in this case, we're going to take this chat ID from the Telegram node. And then the text is going to be, the get request. All right, I should probably rename that so it's easier to find. So so that's the output. So there you go, just direct the output, put it in. And essentially, let's try that up. And go back to our Telegram. As you can see, this is the URL of the video. All right, so cool. Let's get back to the flow. And you know, this time we can punch in, you know, some form of prompt, and we'll see what it spits out. But before we get to that, I also want to highlight that as it happens earlier, right, the video was ready within 30 seconds, and you know, it successfully kind of kicked out the URL output. But in some cases or in some instances, what happens is it takes longer than 30 seconds for it to completely generate the video. Now, in those cases, if your workflow is chained up like this, it's going to stop the flow because basically the HTTP GET request, it's not going to produce anything, right? Because it can't, you know, it's not gonna get any video that because the video is not ready. So what you want to do in that case is add a if node in between to make sure that it goes into a loop, right? So in this case, the result of the get request, we want to take the status. So direct the status to this value here, right? If the status is equal to processing, which usually is what it's going to say, if it's still processing, then what we want to do is so if it's true, we're going to have it wait another 30 seconds. All right. And then we're going to loop it back to the GET request. So just to recap what happens there is that if the status is still processing, which is true, then it's going to wait another 30 seconds and try to get the video again, right? And then this time, if the video is ready, it's going to say completed. So now it doesn't say it's processing, it's false. So it's going to kick it out to the Telegram message. So this loop ensures that, you know, the workflow doesn't break down in the case when the video is not ready within, you know, the specified amount of time that we wait here. Okay, so I think that's all set up now. So let's just try to execute the workflow. And it's waiting for a trigger event. So let's try to chat to the agent here. So hey, can you generate an Instagram video for my sunglasses products based on a trending Netflix show? All right, let's do that. Let's see. So it's getting the input from Telegram. It's kicking it out to Perplexity, which is the research agent. It goes to the video prompt engineer, and now it's kicking it out to Wavespeed, which is the CDance API. And then, you know, it's waiting for the video to generate right now. And so you can see the GET request, not successful. So the status is still ongoing or processing. It's going to wait another 30 seconds, and it's going to try to get it again. Cool. All right. So looks like it's completed. Let's go back to our Telegram. All right. So it seems that there is a link now. It's a download link. So let's see. All right. So these are shades. I'm not sure what this show is from. So I guess it's basing the whole ads based on this particular series here, Bridgerton. Which, you know, is news to me. But anyway, yeah, if that's what people are into nowadays, you know, and if you're selling sunglasses, maybe that's you know, something to look into. But as you can see from the earlier video, you know, it's not the best, in my opinion, if you compare it to VO3, you know, especially without the audio as well. I don't think it's better than VO3. However, one thing to note is that it is definitely much more economical and affordable when you're comparing it to VO3, right? So one of the things that I've noticed when I was using VO3 was just the cost being overly prohibitive in the long run. But yeah, so you know, I'm sure there's many ways to optimize this further. And if you're looking for a cost-effective solution with high quality, I think CDance is definitely worth a shot. And if you're curious as how this compares to the output from VO3, check out my other video where I did a similar AI agent workflow for VO3 instead of CDance. I'll link it up here down below. And just compare kind of the output side by side and see for yourself. So let me know if you face any difficulties or any issues in this build. But otherwise, I will be templatizing this and I'll share the free template you know, in the link below. And so check that out. And if you like the content, please consider subscribing and let me know what are the next workflow that I should do a build along on. But otherwise, catch you on the next one.